Even more than any particular repertoire. Of course, he taught me tunes, but he was a big inspiration in terms of being a great guy, true gentleman. And technically, he's fantastic, obviously. He showed me a lot of his philosophies in terms of fingering and hitting certain notes. As a weekly Irish traditional music columnist for the Irish Echo and as a contributing music writer for the Wall Street Journal, I received many new recordings by promising young or relatively young but accordionists to review or otherwise write about. Very few reveal no influence from Joe Derrane. Triplets in particular are a telltale giveaway. In that proud group, I put David Mumley, Donna's Benny McCarthy, and yes, Dan Gurney sitting there, among many, many others. Along with Brooklyn-born German-American John J. Kimmel, nicknamed the Irish Dutchman, who lived from 1866 to 1942, Joe Derrane is almost a button accordion deity in French Canada, where his technique and style continue to exert enormous influence on young box players there. Even veteran seasoned French-Canadian box players, such as André Bouchard, follow Joe Derrane's music devotedly. On YouTube right now, you can hear André Bouchard play Caprice, a tune Joe composed and recorded on his 1998 album, The Tide of Arms. The weight of influence from Joe Derrane's interpretations of tunes not written by him is also impressive. A tune labeled Joe Derrane's Jig is usually either Hardeman's Fancy or The Fisherman's Widow, neither of which Joe composed. Yet Joe Derrane's Jig can now be found in 96 tune books and has been recorded under that title on no fewer than 45 albums by other artists. Joe didn't like the tune. He's just getting credit with it. That's how powerful the impression of his interpretation is among the community of Irish Jewish musicians. Since 1994, Joe Derrane has recorded far more music than he ever did before then. He has won several Album of the Year honors from the Irish Echo, which also named him Traditional Artist of the Year, a pinnacle accolade, and unprecedented two times, in 1994 and 2010, a breadth of 16 years, attesting to his ongoing creativity and productivity. Since 1994, Joe has additionally been inducted in the Cultus Culturae Aaron's Hall of Fame, been the subject of two film documentaries, as he mentioned, performed in the White House, the President of the United States, and the Irish Prime Minister, appeared on Radio Talk Aaron's Pure Drop program, guested with the chieftains of Boston Symphony Hall, been profiled in many of the major newspapers, and on such radio stations as WGBH-FM in Boston and WFUV-FM in New York City, and he has toured with the American Masters of Celtic Music. Joe is also the subject of lengthy discussion in at least two books. Former Boston Globe music writer Scott Allard's 2003 book, Deep Community, Adventures in the Modern Folk Underground, and Susan Gnudis' 2004 book, See You at the Hall, Boston's Golden Era of Irish Music and Dance. In 2004, as Joe mentioned, Joe received a virtual career capstone, a National Heritage Fellowship. He is still the only Irish public accordionist, and he is still the only Irish traditional musician from New England ever to win that prestigious honor, which recognizes lifetime achievement, artistic excellence, and enduring contributions to the nation's traditional arts heritage. He and 11 other recipients were selected from a strong, narrow pool of 207 candidates, whose credentials were scrutinized over 4 days by a panel of 10 prominent folklorists and ethnomusicologists. It's no finger snap to receive a National Heritage Fellowship. 2004 was also the 10th anniversary year of his comeback at Wolfchester. Joe said to me at the time, you know, maybe God isn't through with me yet. It's actually a statement I made to him even before then. He barked back at me. And I think it's painfully clear that God isn't through with Joe Derrane yet. This is what Mick Maloney wrote in his own essay for Joe Derrane's superb recent album, Grove Lane. Joe Derrane is genial, good natured, good humored, and generous to the extreme. He's also a genius of a musician. Mick Maloney will get no argument from me. Can there be any doubt of the genius and growing impact of Joe Derrane? I'll end with an exchange I had with an ardent fan of Joe Derrane's recent music, who said to me, quote, "Isn't it a shame that he left the Irish public accordion for 35 years? Think of all the great music we missed from him during that time." This is what I said to her, quote, "It would have been a shame only if he had never come back to the Irish public accordion. Think of all the great music we've got from him since." Thank you.